A company selling widgets has found that the number of items sold, X, depends upon the price P at which they're sold, according to the equation X equals 30,000 divided by the square root of the quantity 2P plus 1, where again, X is the quantity and P is the price. Due to inflation and increasing health benefit costs, the company has been increasing the price by $4 per month. Find the rate at which the revenue is changing when the company is selling widgets at $120 each. So our ultimate goal here is to find the rate at which the revenue is changing under these conditions. So let's begin by determining the revenue equation. We know revenue R is equal to the price of the items times the quantity sold, or in this case, P times X. But to write revenue in terms of one variable P, we can make a substitution using this equation here, where we'd have P times this fraction. So we can write the revenue equation as R of P equals, if we multiply P in this fraction, the P would be in the numerator, so we'd have 30,000 P divided by, and now for the denominator, I'm going to write the square root using a rational exponent, so we'll have the quantity 2p plus 1 to the 1/2 power. We're also told the price is increasing by $4 per month, which means dp dt, the change in p with respect to t, is equal to $4 per month. And the current selling price is $120, so we also know p equals 120. And our goal here is to find dr dt. So to find dr dt, we'll have to differentiate both sides of this equation here with respect to t. So we'd have the derivative of r of p with respect to t equals the derivative of this quotient with respect to t. Notice to find this derivative here, we'll have to apply the quotient rule as well as the chain rule because we're differentiating with respect to t, not just p. Let's go and do this on the next slide. The derivative of r with respect to t would just be dr dt. On the right side, we'll have to apply the quotient rule. We'll start with the denominator, which would be the denominator squared. So we'd have the quantity 2p plus 1 to the first power. And now for the numerator, we'll have the denominator times the derivative of the numerator, which would be 30,000 minus the numerator of 30,000 p times the derivative of the denominator, that would be 1/2 times the quantity 2p plus 1 to the negative 1/2 times 2. This requires a chain rule. And because we're differentiating with respect to t, we have a factor of dp dt. Well, now we can find dr dt because we know p and we know dp dt. So let's go ahead and make our substitutions to find dr dt. Notice if p is equal to 120, 2p plus 1 would be 241. So we'd have 241 to the 1/2 times 30,000 minus, this would be 30,000 times 120. Here, notice that the 1/2 and the 2 simplify to 1. And since 2p plus 1 is equal to 241, we have 241 to the negative 1/2 power. All this is going to be divided by just 2p plus 1, or 241. I'm going to multiply this by dp dt, which is 4. Probably one of the most challenging parts about this is entering this correctly into the calculator to get the value of this. So you may want to pause the video to see how I entered this. This is just a fraction. We still have to multiply this result by 4. Again, this is the value of this fraction here, and now times 4. Running to the nearest cent, this would be approximately $3,880.98. So under these conditions, we can say the revenue is increasing at a rate of $3,880.98, and this would be per month. I hope you found this helpful.